Hey everybody, it's Mr. Nordhausen coming to you live from the home studio. And today we're going to take a little break from all things percussion related, which is most of the videos I put out there for you guys. And we're going to play some flute. So don't judge me, I'm a percussionist, okay? I'm doing my best. But I am a band teacher and I do play all the instruments, of course. So we're going to rock out the Summer Song solo. It is a NISMA level 1 solo, and I've even got my flute ninja shirt on. That was a gift from one of my students, so thank you. And yeah, let's get to it, okay? I'm gonna kinda walk us through it if we're gonna pan over here. So this is by William Billingsley and edited by Richard Hahn. Again, it is a NISMA, New York State School Music Association level 1 flute solo. So let's talk about a couple things that are important. Whenever you're looking at music, especially for the first time, the thing you first have to look at is your key signature. And that is the area that is between the clef and the time signature. It's this area right here. Now, in this particular case, we have three flats. B flat, E flat, and A flat. But the key signature could have no flats, could have no sharps, it could have five sharps, could have five, who knows? But this particular piece has three flats. Now, why is that important? Well, it's important because you need then to remember that if you come across any B's, E's, or A's within the music, they need to be played as B flat, E flat, and A flat. So for example, this note right here, if you did not remember your key signature, you'd play that as an A natural, two fingers, right? But you need to remember that it's actually A flat, and therefore you're gonna need three fingers and the pinky, okay? Now also, you might be wondering, well, gee, Mr. N, that flat sign is on the second space, and that note there is on the first ledger line. How is that an A flat? Well, because the key signature is good for all B's, E's, and A's. Doesn't matter if it's lower on the staff or higher on the staff, any and all B's, E's, and A's are flatted, okay? It's also important to note that that key signature does not change for the entire piece of music. So it is indeed all the way through. There's no key changes. You also need to pay attention to your time signature, which for us in this solo is 2/4 time. The top number tells us that there are two beats in a measure. The bottom number of 4 represents the quarter note. So really, 2/4 time means 2 quarter notes per measure. Now that doesn't mean specifically and exactly that there would be 2 quarter notes in every measure. There could be, like this measure again, 1 quarter note, 2 quarter note. Cool, that works. But this measure right next to it does not have 2 quarter notes. It has 4 eighth notes. But 4 eighth notes is the mathematical and rhythmic equivalent of 2 quarter notes. So it might be literal 2 quarter notes, or it might be mathematically and rhythmically equaling 2 quarter notes. That's important as well. Some other things, your tempo, quarter note equals 88. You wanna make sure that you're as close to that as possible when you're performing this. Now, when you're learning it, you're probably gonna wanna take some time off of that, slow the tempo down as you're learning it. A couple other things. Let's make sure we get the articulations correctly. Articulations are how we use our tongue or don't use our tongue. And in a lot of instances here, when we have these groups of 2 eighth notes, we need to slur. So ti-ya, ti-ya, ta, ti-ya, ta, ti-ya, ta. So that second eighth note in every group of 2, you will not articulate with your tongue. You will simply move your fingers to that note. A couple other things, these commas every so often, these are breath marks, so that's where we need to breathe so that we don't interrupt a musical phrase. The 5 bars at the beginning, we can ignore unless you're playing with a piano accompanist, and in which case they would be playing and you'd come in at measure 6. But if you're by yourself, you can come right in on measure 6. These 2 measures you should observe. And then of course we have some dynamic considerations, MF, mezzo forte, cresc right here, which is short for crescendo. We're gonna get louder. Forte, loud. Again, mezzo forte, crescendo. DIM, that's the abbreviation for diminuendo, which means get softer. RIT, which is the abbreviation for ritardando, which means to slow down. A tempo, That means original tempo. So after we slow down here, we will go back to the original tempo that we were prior to slowing down. And that should be about everything. If you're a relatively new flute player, you might want to look up some of these higher notes. That's a high C, that's a high D, that's a high E flat. High E flat is all fingers, okay? High D, I like to tell my students it's the rock on, if I can show you quick. So the rock on symbol is when you do this, right? Rock on, two fingers up, the pointer finger and the pinky finger, right? Don't stick out the thumb, that's I love you. I mean, that's important too, but not for right now. So two fingers out, rock on. A reason why I call that for our D is because you need your thumb in the back and you need those two fingers. So your pointer finger and your pinky finger are not being pressed down. Now, real flute players are probably screaming right now going, but you shouldn't have your fingers so far away. And yes, you're right. Your fingers should be close to the keys at all times. But just as symbolism here, the high D is rock on, and then your pinky in your right hand. So there is the high D. And again, the high E flat is everything, and your high C is the same as your middle C, regular C. So that shouldn't be a big change. You do need to blow faster air as you get higher so that you can produce those upper register notes and not have it drop the octave on you. All right, so I'm gonna play this opening section here. The first three lines, we'll call it the A section, okay? So here we go, summer song, the A section. Here we go. Let me warm up for a second. All right, here we go. We'll call that the A section right there. Hopefully you could hear my articulations of slurring the eighth notes at the right times, breathing at the right times, all of that good stuff. We'd be resting for two bars here, which is only two beats. So one, two, 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 and then boom, you'd be going right on again, okay? So here we go. Let's now go from here, this mezzo forte, after the two measure rest, and we'll go through the ritardando. We'll call this the B section. Okay, here we go. Back to the music, the B section. So that's the B section there, and you notice I got a little quieter and slowed down. And then a tempo, the original tempo. And with the original tempo comes a return to the original material, the A section again. So really, when we talk about the form of a piece of music, the form of a composition, this piece we'd call A, B, A. Or possibly A prime, let me see, yeah, A prime, slightly different at the end, instead of just doing a half note, we're tied on to another half note there, but otherwise, seemingly identical, so this would be A prime, but basically A. So here we go at the a tempo, a reprise of the A section, the beginning. And don't let your pitch bend at the end like I just did as I slightly ran out of air and my pitch bent down a little bit. Don't do that. Be better than me. Okay, so there you have it. Summer Song by William Billingsley, edited by Richard Hahn, a NISMA Level 1 solo, brought to you by Mr. N, the flute ninja, apparently. Have a great day, guys. See ya.